your word. And anytime you sow into the anointing, don't you never forget this. You can't never sow into the anointing and not be blessed. Because anytime you bless God, God come around and bless you back. Your word, the anointing is crying like it's of Osiris.
Yes.
I gave this, and that's to be the devil in your spirit.
Uh-huh.
I take the hell. You're the devil fighting yourself.
Uh-huh.
Because he don't want you to give. Because he knows if you give, you're coming out. He knows if you show, you're coming out. He knows if you give, you're going to have more than enough. He knows the abundant rain coming in your life. So he fights you in your giving. He fights you in your showing. He fights you in your sacrifice. He fights you. He stops, oh my God, my tie, but I don't know, my cock toe, oh God. Look like, oh Father, I thank you for this work. The enemy go to fighting and fighting and fighting. And you're like, well, if I would I could have fixed my car. Amen. The truth is, the devil didn't want you to give it. That's why your car tore up. Y'all got to hear me. Because he knows if you keep giving, amen, you're going to come into abundance. Come on, somebody. Amen. Abundant blessing in your life. Abundant increase, a place of no lack. Come on. The promise of God is no lack. Come on. Shout glory, somebody.
Glory.
You only can do that for if you got love.
Thank you, Lord.
You got to have love to do that. I'm gonna tell you something. Watch this. Don't start giving them stuff away. You want a new wardrobe? Start giving some stuff away. You want some new shoes? Pay the bills. You know you ain't well. Let's start giving them some. Then 6 months from that day when you start something, look in your closet. God, where I get all these shoes?
Free
day. How I get all these suits, man? I got.
Come on.
Look at it. See, the devil mess us up. We know increase come by giving this stuff. But we get bound and stuck in it. God bless you, B.
Hey, give me some of that bone. I got to have. Let me suck on it.
Start giving so some stuff away. And watch the Lord. You're going through because the enemy fighting your soul. He don't want you to be a sore. He don't want you to be, amen, he don't want you to plant into the kingdom because he know when you plant into the kingdom is good chore.
My.
Even in the family.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Even in the family. Even in the family.
My.
Even, I hear you, God.
Ooh.
Even
in the family. Wow.
That's why you can't let the devil talk to you too much because he'll persuade you.
Amen.
You tell that devil, say, you lying to me. I know what God told me. So you didn't move in that neighborhood. That wasn't the neighborhood you're supposed to move in.
Come on.
You never thought about that, did you?
Come on.
You never thought that God didn't want you in that neighborhood for his own reason.
Amen.
It might have been a murderer that you were living next door, an ex-murderer, a maniac. God didn't want you there. You don't understand. God don't have to explain everything to you.
Amen. Amen.
I remember when we were looking for a house. I didn't know how hard it was to get a house at the time. And we looked at the different houses and I didn't even realize that it was a line that you had to stand in because everybody had bid it on the house.
Amen.
And if you go into a previous owner house, the owner that's selling it, he choose who he wants to sell it to.
Amen.
It might be 100 people's house.
Uh-huh.
And so we went to this neighborhood, which is a nice neighborhood, and every neighborhood we was in the line, and I like, my God, and we went to some of the nicest neighborhoods, we went to some neighborhoods that the houses were, you know, $250,000, and amen, and we went, and they had community, all this stuff, and we went, and we was in a long line, and we like, God even went down there, and we cobbled, and amen, and we was in a long line, we and the house was nice, but that wasn't the house that God had for us. See, we was looking for a new house, and God said, I got a new house for you.
All right.
Amen.
A house that we probably would have paid $300,000 for.
Uh-huh.
That when God got done, amen, we just paid like
$187,000.
That's why you don't question God.
Amen.
That's why you got to understand, if he's spoken, he's going to perform it, so don't get upset with it.
Amen.
Somebody don't like this.
Preach, Rev.
Know that God ain't never failed you. God ain't never let you down. And God is not going to let you down. But you got to learn how to give and sow when he speaks to you. See, that's my problem with some of the church folks. God spoke to you, but you ignored God.
Amen.
You walked out with a deaf ear, but now, you know, I need my light bill. I ain't got my... Let me tell you something. Sometimes you have a need and you be on your knees at home praying like, God, I need my light bill paid. I don't know how I'm going to pay the rest of my bill. And God tell you, you get in the church, you got but a little money, God said, give it. And you're like, huh? Mm-hmm. Isn't that crazy? Isn't God crazy? Mm-hmm. Y'all looking at me funny. Ain't God crazy? He gonna tell me to give, and I'm halfway there. Because soon as you give it, God's gonna open my door to pay the whole thing, and now I want that bill and some more bills.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If you don't learn how to sow and trust God, you ain't gonna never come out of your situation. You gotta get out that Levite mentality. Get out that priest, stop turning your head and be a blessing and obey God.
Amen.
Some of you, God might have told you, say, school will come, and I know this is a word for somebody. God might have spoken to you, say, go buy what you call child some school clothes. But guess what? You didn't do it.
Mm.
You didn't obey God, and you didn't know I was looking at you, and I heard God talk to you. You didn't know that, no vision. It wasn't my business. I didn't bring it up to you because that was between you and God. You put somebody child shopping, but you didn't do it. You missed your increase. Did you not know that little child come out of a house of poverty? And they got on their knees and said, God, bless you. With some simple stuff, some school clothes. And God chose you to be the blessing, to be the angel. And you hardened your heart. Because somebody else did something to offend you or you got distracted some kind of way. We won't bless folks because Brown offended me. I was going to do what I ain't doing that now. How many times we got that way?
Amen.
Oh, don't lie to yourself.
Praise the rail.
Thank you, Jesus.
But guess what? You disobeyed God.
Thank you, Jesus.
You missed your miracle.
Mm.
You missed your deliverance.
Mm.
Watch me in 6 months from this day. Start sowing. You want to never be broke again? Start giving. Start disobeying God. Don't get crazy. Now, don't let no demon get in your spirit. Just ask God, say, God,